Hey yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays today on Acid Plant, a latter edition. I think sometimes I called it Acid Planet, but it's Acid Plant with a TVZ today, as we have in the top left hand side in the blue, it's the Zerg player Flops. And in the bottom right hand side in the red, it's me, the Red Terran Alexasher. And I don't know who this guy is. Maybe some VIP. Flaps is a very good Zerg player in Master League, I have to say. I play him, yeah, I would say frequently, since a year, maybe two, I don't know, at least I remember his name. If you would go through all my TVCs, I'm sure you will see him at some point, definitely. I'm pretty sure, if I recorded it. I think I did, but I'm not so sure. If I recorded it, but I should. At least I played him. Don't know what he meant with that. Maybe he broke his new keyboard. Or he bought a new keyboard and now he doesn't know how to use it and needs to get used to it. No clue. I don't know. But yeah, TVC is definitely different to TVP, I would say. Which we had the last couple of videos. So he's going for a hatch pool. And with the lack of gas guys over here, it looks like he's going for a very early hatchery, a third hatch as well. Somewhere. At least I guess so. Yeah, so maybe double queen and then hatchery. I don't know, at least there's no gas, so he needs to go for a hatchery somewhere. At least not at the gold bases. That still is a valid strategy. You can go. You can go for the gold base potentially and then play a Roach Ravatrol in with speedlings, for example, and just crank out so many units. It's still possible, especially on a map where you can't proxy a gold base. It's definitely doable, and it's not that easy to scout either. It's because if you go in with the Reaper, everything looks quite normal. Just the lack of third base is like maybe, and by the time when you check that he's not going for a lair tag, it's almost too late to react. So very difficult to scout. And yeah, he goes for a third base. It's a little bit late in my opinion, but what do I know? I don't play Zerg. Reaper gets shoot away, and for me it looks like I'm playing like the same opening I play against. Protoss so far with the Widowmine drop. It's still Widowmines can be nice against Zerg, but most TVCs nowadays, if you watch Maru, TY, Gumiho, okay, maybe not Gumiho because he plays mech most of the time. Innovation plays a lot of mech as well against Zerg, but he also plays bio, and what you see there. Most of the time is Hellion opening. You will most likely see a lot of Hellion openings. So that's that. Yeah. I like that he's starting his creep spread currently. That's looking great. And oh, he loses an overlord. That's a pity. But it's not supply capping him, so that's not too bad for him. At least I would say he definitely can work with that. I should have killed this overlord. He definitely saw the Widowmines moving across the map. He will see it there. He will see it there. He should be so prepared, not losing anything. Maybe I should have dropped here. Looks like he's going for Baneling Nest and double Evo Chamber, standard stuff as well. Yeah, I like that he's also creep spreading in the space. There are the queens coming, so yeah, this is not dealing any damage. One missile onto the egg, the other one onto the queen, not killing anything. At least I don't lose the medivac. I forced some lost mining time, which you can see here. for 10, 20 seconds. That's not too bad, but it's no real economic damage. So he's ahead 10 drones, which is totally fine for him. I would need to take my gas soon. Looks like I'm trying to establish some kind of two-base attack? I don't know, maybe that's the wrong decision to do here, but that seems to be exactly the case. He's going for a lair tech now, which I like. His creep spread is looking really strong. That's what I meant with Flaps is a pretty good Zerg player. Sure, he's not GM, but I'm neither. And for Master Zerg, he has his mechanics on point, I would say. He's doing the right things at the right time. Sure, he could spread creep now here and now here and go up there and all that stuff. Spend his money on something, I would say. Sure, but he's looking good. If you see that he has the fourth base on the way. I don't have the third base on the way. I'm really playing as it looks like TVP build with the two base attack. And I'm not sure if this can work at all. And you see, that's the problem what you get if you attack move across the map. The flying units will fly. And oh, the Raven. Oh my goodness. Oh, it's a low 12 HP. So now he can look at that. He was on 7, 6, 30, still only on 7 queens. But now he saw. Now I should attack, but I'm not, so my all-in, my two-base push, I should say, is delayed by a lot. And that's not good. I give him like one extra minute time to prepare. And he is preparing. Look at that, so many banelings. If I would have attacked earlier, this could have been disastrous. But so I like his creep spread a lot. The Raven is here now, so I like the Raven in TVC because you don't need to scan to creep to clear creep. However, there are 1,000 billion banelings crashing into all those marauders. The splits of the marines are decent, but is it enough? I don't know. It's looking so close. It looks like I barely have enough. I'm killing on overlord back there. He still has so many banelings. Yeah, he's wasting lots of banelings now. That was bad out of his part. The Widowmine's here, killing stuff, but I get taken out as well. Four marines. I lost the Raven, as it looks like, so now I need to scan. And with the amount of creep tumors he has, I need a lot more units to clear this with one scan. So either I scan more, or I have more units. But currently he's looking quite good. He's 20 army supply behind, but as it's encirclings and banelings, that should be fine, I would say. At least he has the economy. He's like 30 worker ahead, which is so much more. I can't clear the creep, so his circlings can attack here. And his banelings just go in, crushing my army, as it looks like. And yeah, he can clear this easy going. No problem at all, as it looks like, so what you gonna do when I come for you? I don't know. He's getting a infestation pit back. I still don't have the third base taken, but it looks like I broke him. I break in. I can target fire the bandings, which I'm doing. It's 1-1 against 1-1, so that's fine. He needs to pull back his worker. I like that trick. That's not too bad. The medivacs are out of energy. I see more bandings morphing here. The position of the Spire is definitely questionable. Gets taken out. GG Spire, that's expensive. 200 down the toilet, but other than that, it's looking not too bad. I mean, the supplies are equal, but he's going to Hive Tech now. 2-2 on the way for him, not for me, so I'm still on 1-1. And I can tell you, 2-2 against 1-1, whoever got the upgrade advantage has a very big advantage. Oh, the Widowmine hit! That was so disastrous. 10 banelings, at least, I would say, killed there. This base is gone, so it's 3 base against 3 base. Now, just now, I'm taking this base at the 10 minute mark, super late, because the main base halfway dried out. The Widowmines get taken out here, but killing lots of you. Oh no. Ooh, okay. 12 kills on that bad boy. I should repair the medivacs. The medivacs have no more energy. Still no 2-2 from me, so it looks like I don't want any upgrades. However, I could fire them up and I should start them as soon as possible. Because fighting circlings against marines with 1-1 against 2-2 is bad. Whoever got the advantage has advantage. And he will have the advantage for like 2 minutes or something. That's a lot. There's the troll swarm host. Not sure why he's getting that bad boy. Maybe just to harass or be annoying. Another scan. I don't think I will see this creep tumor. Nope, I don't. So at least I get a clear path between this now for fifth base and this natural. The splits are decent enough, I would say, but not enough units to really contest that amount of banings and circlings. And as you can see at the 11 minute mark, he still is only on 11 on circlings and banelings as tech. No mutalisk, no ultralisk, no nothing, just Ling Bane all day long. No Hydras either, so that's weird, but he makes it work. And he's 20 army supply behind, however, he still attacks me. He has driven me back. The big thing is, even though he got the upgrade advantage right now, he doesn't have. Oh! He doesn't have anything or so many circlings! Woo! But the position of my units is good. What I wanted to say, oh, he's killing a lot of SCVs, so the income should definitely look good for him. Yeah, definitely does. What I wanted to say is he doesn't have anything against the medivacs. If you play normally in Heart of the Swarm, you played Mutalisk. Not only because of the harassment, but because you can kill the medivacs. They were a mobile flying heresy unit which you could use to snipe Widowmines, medivacs, snipe worker, and so on. And as soon as Zerg doesn't have anything against medivacs, and you get like up to 16 or 14, things are looking very dangerous for Zerg. This Widowmine splashing, well, okay. Not the best splash there, but it's fine. Big Stim coming in. Where is his army? There is no army. He's 40 supply behind. I think what he's missing are queens. Yeah, where are his queens? He got 2 queens. That's his problem. At some point he lost all his queens. That Baneling attack is nice, but he can't spend his money. And that's costing him. If he would go up into Broodlords now, or he's killed the Spire. With Broodlords he could do it, or with Ultralisk. Potentially, it would at least help a little bit. I would need to drop more. So instead of getting queens, he got proc macro hatchers, which is nice. But queens are better than getting macro hatcheries. He should have gotten queens. So his larva count is so low, he can't keep up with my production, and that means that I can out spam. Or out-produce a Zerg player, and that should never happen. If you can out-produce a Zerg player, look at that attack. It's a really low attack, so all those little... Just imagine some Hydralisk there, killing all the medivacs, resetting the medivac count, that would be so good. He's getting into the Widowmines again here. Well, I don't think he can do this. It's 2-2 against 2-2 now, 3-3 on the way for both of us. But I'm more. I still like his creep spread, even though he doesn't have any queens left to spread creep. He's 2 queens for injects, and that's it. But his creep spread is still solid. More banelings coming in. Do I react in time? Oh, quite. Not really, but quite. And now you need to go all the way across. Oh my goodness. And in the meantime I can attack here. I think he can maybe clear this. No, I think he's about to lose this. I'm 45 army supply ahead. Yeah, so even though he can't clear this, he loses another base. How many hatcheries did die? So for 3 hatcheries and 74 tumors. Look at that. And here we have so many units died. The swarm host did nothing, I never saw it. And the unit loss tab is looking very good for me. 10,000 different, 9,000 different. That's the difference, that's a lot. However, he manages to do some counterattack, but the Banes are crossing into the Marauder. That's always bad. You want the Banes to cross into either SCVs, mules, potentially, but most likely into Marines to kill them. Two Banelings, if they get good connection with Burrow, for example, can instantaneously kill 12 Marines, maybe 14, I would say. Maybe 16, but that's a little bit much, but two Banelings for 10 Marines is a good trade. So like that, that's a good trade. But can he keep up, can he produce? I mean, look at the medivacs, there are so many medivacs. Still getting... And I'm just now getting more... barracks. Somewhere. There we go. And there's another counterattack out of him, but I don't think he can do this. I saw that, so I should be prepared. The planetary is safe, and yeah, he can't do much. He does have 3-3 on the circlings. So that's nice. He also has the adrenal glands. Which make the circ the speedlings to cracklings. So they attack faster, but it's looking really bad. He's getting chitinous plate now for ultralisk, but he doesn't have the lava, the money. He's low on income. He's behind 15 drones. That base is oversaturated, this is undersaturated, this is dry. So what do you want to do? And this base will fall potentially next. Another big Baneling attack. Can clear everything, so that's good, but he's not trading correctly in my opinion. Look at that, 15,000 resources lost more than me. And the Spinecrawler is a nice adaptation, but will just get cancelled. And yeah, the Banes into the Marauder, that's the thing. The Marauder is a strong unit, 4 armor. And the Banelings don't deal much damage, like 10, 12 damage? I don't know. Does he have any Banelings? No. He has nothing! Nothing left! He's getting some Corruptor and some Circlings, and that's it. That's not enough. There's still a Widowmine here. Got 8 kills, as it looks like. Look at the fleet of medivacs, so many medivacs, and I'm not stopping there. There we go, GG finally realizes that's it. Thank you so much for watching, hope you enjoyed as always. I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.